Good morning, everybody. Can you hear the mic good?
Yeah. I can hear you.
Okay.
We can hear you.
Okay. I'm going to give you some information about the songs before we sing them. And these songs here I pulled, they go all from 1929 all the way up to 1950. And some of the songs you'll probably recognize, but you probably haven't heard for a while. Now, with the song In My Heart, it appeared in a movie with Glenn Hunter in 1929. The musical is Spring Is Here presented a problem he couldn't sing, and I gave Roger and Hart gave him with a song In My Heart and to more vocally gifted rival, John Hurley. So this was in 1929 that it came out with a song In My Heart.
With a song in my heart, I behold your adorable face. Just a song and the star, but it soon is a hymn to your grace. When the music swells, I'm touching your hand.
It came out in 1938, but it wasn't popular then at all. It got popular in 1955 when Frank Sinatra sang it. And Frank Sinatra sang that, and it won an Emmy Award, thank you, for the healthy home sentiment. It also won the religious Christopher Award. Play it and you'll understand why. So it won awards, but not until Frank Sinatra sang it. And you have to forgive me because my brain ain't working too well. Okay, Love and Marriage.
Love and Marriage, Love and Marriage. Together like a horse and carriage. I tell you, brother, you can't have one without the other. Love and marriage, love and marriage. It's an institute you can't disparage. Ask the local gentry, and they will say it's elementary.
I couldn't find too much information on that, except that it was copyright 1956, and it was by Cole Porter. And Cole Porter had a musical, and actually it was put in a trust. So So there's not too much information about that that I could find. And it's probably out there, but I couldn't find it. So true love.
It wasn't in
The this was in a movie called High Society with Grace Kelly and Bing Crosby.
I remember that.
Don't you?
Yeah.
A great movie.
That's true love. You found it.
Let's see. Suntan, wind blown, honeymooners at last alone, feeling far above par. Oh, how lucky we are. Give to you as you give to me, true love. Nothing to do but to give to you as you give to me, love forever true. But I give to you and you give to me, true love.
It's Cole Porter. A lot of these songs from Cole Porter, they were in so many musicals that it's hard to keep track. But it first came out in 1938. So that's when this song was first sang, in 1938.
No. I And if you want to go walking here,
it's delightful, it's delicious, it's lovely.
I understand the reason why you sentimental men so am I.
It's delightful, it's delicious, it's lovely.
Someday my prince will come.
He hasn't come yet.
She's 107.
Hello, everybody. Is that okay? Someday my prince will come. Someday I'll find my love, and how thrilling that moment will be when the prince of my dreams comes to me. We'll whisper. whisper, I love you, and steal a kiss or two. Though he's far away, I'll find my love someday, someday when my dreams come true. Someday I'll find my love, someone to call my own, and I'll know him the moment we meet, for my heart will stop skipping a beat. Someday we'll say and do things we've been longing to, though he's far away, I'll find my love today, someday when my dreams come true.
Thank you. We have Mim's going to tell you a couple of jokes now.
Well, that's me. I'm him. And, well, I understand this woman. She was an elderly woman. She decided to prepare her will. So she went to her preacher and she said she had two final requests. First, she wanted to be cremated, which isn't bad, you know. She was going to have a hot time in the old town before she went. Second, she wanted her ashes spread over Walmart. Now, the preacher said, Walmart? She said, well, yeah. I figure this way my daughters will get to see me at least twice a week. Now, another one is, and I know a lot of us have this problem, I do. Do you know how to prevent sagging? You know, sagging here. I'll start to sag a little. Well, what you do is you just keep eating till the wrinkles fill out. What do you think? You like that one?
Doesn't work.
Well,
that is
they kind of do. All right, another one. The senility prayer. Grant me the senility to forgive the people I never liked anyway, the good fortune to run into the ones I do, and the eyesight to tell the difference. Ah, well, wait a minute now, let's see what else I got. Did you hear about the kidnapping?
No.
Tell
us.
You woke up.
Sounds like a Frank Turner one.
Hey, no comments out there. I'm doing this for free.
Thank goodness.
Is that you, Leo? Okay, now what about dogs? Or why are dogs like phones?
Why?
They have caller IDs.
Oh!
I got a couple of these off the sign down the street from my house. And some of them my 11-year-old grandson gave me.
Mim, I have one I'm going to whisper to you.
No whispering.
All right. To get over one, you should get under another.
Once you get over one, you should get
under
another. Oh, boy.
Did you hear that?
She brings her friends.
repeat it. If you didn't hear the first one, I'm not repeating it. What do you call a group of apes when they go into wait a minute. What do you call a group of apes when they start a company? You got one? You got an answer?
Business.
Monkey business. Oh. See, I'm trying to keep these all clean.
Yeah.
If I told the dirty joke, could understand it.
I'll get it right next time, ma'am. I'll get it right next time.
Okay. I was going on a diet, but right now I got too much on my plate. What do you think?
I like it.
Okay, now, when you go into a bathroom or come out of a bathroom, you're American. But when you're in the bathroom, you're European. That's it.
Okay, the next song we're going to sing is Let Me Call You Sweetheart.
Oh, I can sing that.
No, listen.
Very good.
This here was on a cakewalk in the turn of the century. Mr. Wilson, 1879. Only to watch it sell 2 million copies.
Wow.
On a sheet music. The following year, they wrote Sweetheart, which they changed, not Let Me Call You Sweetheart, they just put it Sweetheart, which sold 5 million copies. But this time, they had been shrewd enough to make a contract for royalties on every copy sold. This is the only song that, unless you buy the book or you buy it, you cannot get it. You cannot get it online. You have to buy it. So, Let Me Call You Sweetheart, I'm in love with you.
You mean we had to pay for this?
I had to pay for it.
We don't get paid here. We
got to
pay for the music.
I pay for a lot of the music.
That you don't know. As time goes by, you probably know the phrase, play it again, Sam. Okay? It was produced in 1931, but it didn't become popular until 11 years later. The first thing that it was in was Everybody's Welcome. I never heard that play or whatever.
But Casablanca made it very famous. So that's the information about As Time Goes By. And who was the actor? Anybody know?
Humphrey Bogart.
Humphrey Bogart, right.
You must remember this. Our kiss is just a kiss, a sigh just a sigh. The fundamental things apart as time goes by. And when two lovers woo, they still say I love you. On that you can rely.
This won a British songwriting contest in 1945. It achieved worldwide fame in World War II when the HMS, I think it's Marine Corps, the crew sang this song as they defeated China guns in the USA. Both Bluebird, Pratt Barrett, and Ross Martin accorded 1 million selling versions of it. So, Cruising Down the River. There is a couple of different versions, but it's about the same.
Cruising down the river on a Sunday afternoon, with one you love, the sun above, waiting for the moon. The old accordion playing a sentimental tune, cruising down the river on a Sunday afternoon. The birds above all sing of love, a gentle sweet refrain. The winds around all make a sound like softly falling rain. Just two of us together will plan a honeymoon. Cruising down the river on a Sunday afternoon.
Ever heard my husband sing more than 60 years ago.
She begged him, don't sing it again. It's really good.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
The next song is called Memories. But this song here, there is so many, so many copies of it. It's thanks for the memories. These foolish things remind me of you, moments to remember. The song had plenty of competition back in 1955. Children's voices everywhere kept piping the ballad of Davy Crockett, while adults marched along to Mitch Miller's Roasting Virgin, The Yellow Rose of Texas. Then the Canadian quartet known as the Four Lads recorded Moments to Remember.
That was
Yeah, that there had 1 million sellers on hand. But not only was it one of the biggest hits of that year, but later proved to be the song by which many of those growing up in the 1950s now remember a decade later. So that they had parts of this song were in all of the other songs that you sing, which I didn't realize that. Ready? Okay.
January to December, we'll have moments to remember. The New Year's Eve, we did the town. The day we tore the goalposts down, we will have these moments to remember. The quiet walks, the noisy fun, the ballroom prize we almost won. We will have these moments to remember. Oh, summer turns to winter, and the present disappears. The laughter we were glad to share will echo through the years. When other nights and other days may find us gone our separate ways, we will have these moments to remember.
Question. How many were alive in the 50s?
I saw these guys singing at the Beach Casino.
Yeah, I was too. How about the 40s?
Oh, get out of here.
You don't have to do
it.
How about the 30s?
We got the 30s in here too. Well, I was just curious about the 50s, that's all.
Okay, the next song is by a composer, Francis Crane, which a lot of people don't know. I didn't have too much information what movies this was in, but the lyrics were by Kermit Gowell, which probably people that you don't really hear of. It was first produced in 1947, became popular in 1974. So near you.
That was from a zombie movie, I think.
The sung by the Andrews Sisters.
It was sung by the Andrews Sisters in 1947.
Yep. That's what I said, zombie movie. Andrews Sisters.
There's just one more place for me.
Like heaven to be near you. Times when we're apart, I can't face my heart. Say you'll never stray more than just two lips away. If my hours could be spent near you, I'd be more. Near you, make my life worthwhile by telling me that I'll spend the rest of my days near you, near you.
The next song is I Got the World on a String. And these are two other lyrics that you never heard of in music. One was Ted Kosher, and the music was by Harold Arlen. It was first published in 1932, became popular in 1960. And I think it was popular in one of the circus
movies that won. I don't remember just what it was, but I remember hearing it on the TV on one of the, I don't know what, if it was the Ringling Brothers for the circus or one of them, but I couldn't find out that information. Of course, I didn't look very hard.
By the way,
I got the world on a string.
Ted Kohler also, if you check at home, invented a toilet. Kohler. Kohler toilets.
It ain't Kohler. It's not spelled that way.
The world of a string, sitting on the rainbow,
got
a string around my finger. What a world, what a life, I belong. From the song you all sing, I can make the rainbow. Can't you see? I'm in love. Life's a beautiful thing. As long as I hold the string, I'd be a silly so-and-so if I should ever let it go. I got the world on a string, sitting on the rainbow.
Win a race.
Strings.
You know, like we just sang about a string. Why don't strings win a race? Because they always tie. Sorry, just had to throw that in.
That's all right.
This
is
the next song we're going to sing is Fly Me to the Moon. Now the words and the music were by Bart Howard. He's the first one that wrote this. Who made it famous was Dean Martin and Frank Sinatra. And it was published, and let me see, in 1954. Fly Me to the Moon. I didn't bring my book, so I don't know when it was actually produced, but this song here, I love. I sang it professionally for a wedding, two weddings actually. So hopefully I'll do good for you tonight. Ready? when somebody loves you, it's no good unless he loves you all the way. Happy to be near you when you need someone to cheer you, come what may. Taller than the tallest tree is, that's how high it's got to be. Deeper than the deep blue sea is, that's how deep it goes if it's real. When somebody needs you, it's no good unless he needs you all the way. For the good and bad years and all the in-between years, come what may. Who knows where the road would lead us? Only a fool would say. But if I'm gonna love you, it's for sure I'm gonna love you all the way.
Okay, the next song we're going to sing is Always. And,
no information on this one. Okay. You got information on yours? I think it's an old song, but I think you're really going to enjoy it. I liked it. Okay.
You want to start it with the orange? You want me to
check it? Christmas time, we killed off Grandma. Grandma got run over by a reindeer.
Really sorry.
So this time, this is a John Denver tune. It's called Grandma's Feather Bed. It's probably written in the 70s or early 80s.
Yeah.
It was in the 70s. So.
Yeah.
When I was just a little wee boy, just up off the floor, we used to go down to Grandma's house every month and or so. We'd chicken pie and country ham, homemade butter on the bread. The best odd thing about Grandma's house was the great big feather bed. It was 9 feet high, 6 feet wide, soft in the downy chick. It was made from the feather of 4011 geese. Took a whole bunch of fun for the chick. Old egg kids, no hound dog, and a baby we stole from the shed. We didn't get much sleep, but we had a lot of fun on Grandma's feather bed. After supper, we'd sit around the fire, the old folks spit and chew. Pa would talk about the bomb and the war, and Granny'd sing a ballad or two. I'd sit and listen and watch the fire till the cobwebs filled my head. Next thing I know, I'd wake up in the morning in the middle of the old feather bed. It was 9 feet high, 6 feet wide, and soft in the downy chip. It was made from the feathers of 4011 geese, took a whole load of fun from the chip. Whole day kids, four hound dogs, and a baby we stole from the shed. We We didn't get much sleep, probably had a lot of fun on Grandma's feather bed. Well, I love my ma, and I love my pa, and Granny and Grandpa too. Did fishing with my uncle, wrestling with my cousin, I even kissed Aunt Lou.
Ew!
And if I ever had to make a check, guess it ought to be said. I trade them all, plus the gal down the road. Well, maybe not the gal down the road, but Grandma's feather bed. It was 9 feet high, 6 feet wide, soft as a downy chick. It was made from the feathers of 411 geese, took a hole from the clock for the chick. It'll hold a kid, 400 dogs, a baby's tall from the shed. We didn't get much sleep, but we had a lot of fun on Grandma's feather bed. We didn't get much sleep, but we had a lot of fun on Grandma's feather bed.
For the music. Okay, the last song we always sing is God Bless America. Everybody stand, please. If you can.
Yeah, we should go in the school.
Thank you, Carol, for recording us.